Dear students, in this lecture we are going to study first order reactions and its derivation. In a first order reaction, the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reacting substance. So in this case, A is the reactant and it gives a product. So A is only a reactant involved in this reaction, and the rate of such reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reacting substance which is involved in the reaction. So rate of reaction is nothing but minus dc by dt. So change in concentration of reactant with respect to time is equal to k into c. So k is nothing but the proportionality constant. It is known as specific reaction rate or velocity constant, and C is the molar concentration of reactant A. So we see this equation, rate equation, minus dc by dt is equal to k into C. If suppose when the concentration of the reactant C is unity, then this specific reaction rate or velocity constant becomes equal to the rate constant minus dc by dt. So the specific reaction rate or velocity constant of reaction is may be defined as the velocity constant is the rate of reaction when the concentration of the reactant C is unity. The reaction rate at any given instant, suppose a reaction is taking place and we are going to calculate the rate of such a reaction, then reaction rate of such reactions at any instant depends or equal to the product of specific reaction rate and the concentration of the reactant at that instant. So the rate of reaction depends upon the velocity constant and the concentration at that instant. Now if suppose A is the concentration, so A gives a product, then A is the initial concentration of reactant A, X is nothing but amount of reactant reacted or amount of product which is formed in this reaction at certain time t. If A minus X is the amount of reactant remains at time t, so A minus X is the remaining concentration of the reactant at time t, then the rate equation can be written here. Dx by dt is directly proportional to A minus X. So we just learn that rate of reaction depends upon the rate constant, that is K, and the concentration of reactant at that instant. So A minus X is nothing but the concentration of reactant at time dt. So dx by dt is equal to, so K is proportionally constant, K A minus X. So this is the equation number 2. If we integrate this equation number 2, then we have this equation, integration of dx by, so I have taken this A minus X at the left hand side at the denominator. So dx by A minus X is equal to K integration of dt. So by integrating this equation number 3, we have this equation, natural negative sign of natural log of A minus X is equal to K into t plus K dash. So this K dash is nothing but it is the constant of integration. So we can calculate, we can calculate this K dash by use of the values, by putting the value of X is equal to 0 and T is equal to 0 in this equation. So we are going to put these values. So negative natural log of A minus, so X value is 0, is equal to K t value is 0, therefore t k into 0 plus k dash. So then natural log of a minus 0 is a is equal to k into 0 is 0 plus k dash. Therefore we have this equation, we got the value of k dash, and by putting this value of k dash in equation number 4, then so now I will write here, putting equation 5 in equation number 4, then we have this new equation, negative natural log of a minus x is equal to k into t plus, so k dash the value is the k dash value is negative natural log of a. So this is equation number 6. So I will take this negative natural log of a at the left hand side, then negative natural log of a, so it becomes positive. So this equation as it is, natural log of a minus x is equal to k into t. So this is the equation number 7. Or we can write this equation as like this, natural log of a upon a minus x is equal to k into t. So this is equation number 8. So this equation number 7 can be written as like in equation number 8. If we convert this natural log into the log to the base 10, then now see here, converting to log to the base 10, then we have this equation 2.303 log to the base 10 a upon a minus x is equal to k into t. So now, so k is equal to 2.303 divided by 2.303 log to the base 10 a upon a minus x. So this t value is written as here. So 2.303 divided by t log to the base 10 a upon a minus x. So this is the final equation or integrated rate equation for the first order reaction. So this equation is called as an integrated rate equation. Integrated rate equation for first order reaction. Integrated rate equation for the first order reaction. K is equal to 2.303 divided by T log to the base 10 A upon A minus X, where A is the initial concentration of the reactant and A minus X is the concentration of reactant after time T. Okay, now see here, again I will repeat this derivation. So this is the general equation reaction. A gives a product. Suppose a small a is the initial concentration of this reactant at time t. Suppose some amount of reactant is converted into the product, then x is that amount which is converted into the product, or x amount of reactant is reacted at time t. Then the remaining concentration of reactant a is a minus x. So a minus x is nothing but the remaining amount of concentration of reactant at time t. Then we write the rate equation in terms of this derivation. Dx by dt is directly proportional to a minus x. So the potential constant is k here. Now dx by dt is equal to k into a minus x, equation number 2. If we integrate this equation 2 and by rearranging, then dx by a minus x is equal to k integration of dt. By integrating this equation, we have this equation number 4, negative sign of natural log of a minus x is equal to kt plus k dash. So k dash is nothing but constant of integration. So it can be calculated by putting the value of x is equal to 0 and t is equal to 0 in equation number 4. So by putting these values, we have this k dash value, negative natural log of a. By putting the value of k dash in equation number 4, we have this equation, negative natural log of a minus x is equal to k into t minus natural log of a. So by taking the value of negative sine of ln natural log of a at the left hand side, then we have this equation number 7, or we may write the equation number 7 in terms of this equation number 8, natural log of a upon a minus x is equal to k into t. By converting this equation 8 to the log 10, then we have this equation 2.303 log to the base 10 a upon a minus x k into t. So t is taken at the left hand side, then k is equal to 2.303 divided by t log to the base 10 a upon a minus x. So this is the integrated rate equation for the first order reaction, where a is the initial concentration, a minus x is the concentration of reactant after certain time t. This equation is written in terms of this negative sine of dc by c. So the concentration tends from c0 to c is equal to k into dt. So the time is from 0 to t time. Then we can say here that c0 is nothing but initial concentration of reactant. C is the concentration at time t, concentration of reactant at time t. Then we can write this equation as natural log of c0 upon c is equal to k into t. This is the equation number 10, and by rearrangement then it is written as k is equal to 1 by t natural log of c0 by c. If you convert this equation 11 in terms of log to the base 10 value, then k is equal to 2.303 divided by t log to the base 10 c0 by c. So this is the equation number 12, where c0 is nothing but the concentration of reactant at initial time and c is the concentration after time t. So this is the general integrated equation. We can use this equation to calculate the rate of different reactions. Next